Hello friends, I hope you are well. In this video, I will show you my due diligence on Lofty AI properties. So if you don't know Lofty AI, this is a crowdfunding real estate company in the United States and it specializes in tokenized real estate. So I'm an investor in crowdfunding real estate for many years now. So I've been investing in many platforms. Most of them are in Europe, but also in the United States. So all of them are on my website that you can find, and you will find the link in the description of the video. So now I will show you all my finding and about Lofty AI properties, which is quite interesting. And I will show you how to perform a due diligence in order to avoid to pay a property too high. So you can do those investigation yourself. I will provide all the link in the description of the video. So I will show two properties, one in Cleveland, one in Chicago, because the thing are slightly different. But at the end, we may have an artificial price. It means a price that is a bit too high compared to the market. And this is an off-market price. So, from my point of view, of course, this is my opinion. You follow the video and you make up your mind. There is no issue with that. You put a comment if you want, and we can discuss further. So first thing first, I took this one in Cleveland. So this property, it's available on the website. It's still for sale, you see, because it's been only 81% has been funded already. So there's still pending investment. So this property, basically, it give a yield of 6.6%, and the total investment, so the is 162,000 dollars. So just remember $162. This is the price of this property, which been splitted, like you buy some shares that are represented by token. So you can buy like a $50 token, etc. But the price of the purchase price is 162. And the question is this a fair price? Is 162K a fair price for this property in Cleveland? And maybe you don't know the market, but let me show you a few things. So if you click on this link, you will access the purchase document, you know, the purchase agreement. Okay. This is here. This purchase agreement, you can see the price it has been sold for $145,000. So you say, okay, this is, the price has been sold. So it's fine. So it means Lofty AI bought to the owner, to the previous owner, to the seller, 145. So there is no reason to doubt of this price, because this is a price Lofty AI has bought this property. Are you sure of that? So basically, Lofty AI, you see, is here. This is the Lofty holding, bought to the seller, which is MFR 5 LLC. So this is a limited liability company. So this, they bought to a company. But may you wonder who is behind this company? So because the price was a bit higher than what I thought, so I made some research, and I found out that this was sold on the 19th of July. But when was the previous sale? The previous sale was just the 16th of July. It means 3 days before. So 3 days before, it was sold already at 70,000. So in 3 days, the price went up from 70,000 to 145,000. Weird, no? Strange. Yeah. And before, you can see that in 2009, it was 45,000. So 45,000 switched to 70,000. Then it switched to 145,000 suddenly in 3 days. So who is behind MFR? So MFR 5, I found the company. The company is incorporated in the Wyoming. So this is the Wyoming business search. So you can search for any company. So I found this company. Okay. Then I just click on the last report, the 2021 report, which is public. You can do that yourself. I mean, there is nothing hidden. And I found out that in this report, I see a name, Eric Martel. So Eric Martel, which is like the director of this company, and probably the shareholder as well. Okay. So he has the power to sign everything, to sign any purchase and anything. They say, yeah, fair enough. And who is Eric Martel? Now you go to the Lofty AI team. And actually, you see a name that you may recognize. It's not Eric. It's Antoine. Probably same family, like two brothers or something like that. So family members. So basically what happened? So Eric, let's say, I don't know, Antoine's brother, bought this house for 70,000 or something. Yeah, here. You see, it was bought by MFR. So Eric bought at 70,000 and 3 days later, sell to Lofty AI. It means his brother's company at 145,000. It means double. It means 100% price increase within 3 days. Amazing. I love this real estate. And this was sell to whom? To us, to the investor who invests through the platform. Yeah. So this is one, you see. So clearly, from my point of view, this is not the fair price. This is an off market. So investors are buying too high. Now I show you another one in Chicago, same platform. Okay. So here we are in Chicago. Okay. This address. Again, this one is available on the platform. It's still for sale. Only 58% has been funded already. So, I mean, it's at the time I'm doing this video. I mean, I'm doing this video in 27 of December 2021. So it's still available. So I don't know when you will see this video, but most likely it will still be available. Okay. So then the price of this house is 341,000. Okay. So just remember 340,000. Okay. Same thing. This property, I mean, you may have like suspicion. Say, okay, wow, this is expensive for a property that has been built in 1900. Let's see, because maybe it's not well maintained. So let's have a look. So first thing. You can see that the property was sold, so was bought by Lofty Holding, so same thing, but it was not bought to MFR, it was bought to the seller, which is Odai Almar. So simple, there is no company hiding, who is behind, etc. So there is everything you should trust. Are you sure? Yeah, that's how to do the due diligence. You know, some people stop there and some people dig further. And the more you dig, the more you find. And I found. So welcome to the Tokenization Bureau of Investigation. You know, I provide due diligence to make sure we don't make mistakes when we invest. So don't forget to subscribe to my channel. If you want more due diligence on other company, put in the comment. Okay, so let's continue. So this property, which was sold to Lofty AI for us to invest, it was sold 340,000. But look at the state. Look at how is this the state of how it is maintained. So you see, it needs to be needs to be sealed with sealant. I mean, the rooftop not in good condition. You cannot even, the lock is not working, the window broken. yeah, it's not well maintained. Yeah. It's not well maintained. So you may wonder, what's the price of this, what's the fair price? What's the fair value of this property? Okay, so I had a look, you know, at the previous when it was sold previously, and you can see that on July 2021 it was sold for 200,000. 200,000, and 3 months later, you remember? Here we are, 3 months later. Let me search for. Yeah. Not even, you know. It's almost at the same. It's crazy, man. It's crazy. Almost at the same price, at the same time, it was sold. So yeah. October, you see? October 2021, it was sold for 300. So it moved from, it moved from 200 to 330,000. Look at that. July, October. Like, it's almost like 70% increase within 3 months. But even, you know, while I'm doing this video, actually, I checked that the signature of, so this is Odai, you know, selling to Jerry Chu, which is the founder, the CEO of the company of Lofty AI. It's even in June, you know, and this one was even in May. So this is crazy, man, because you see that actually Odai bought at 200 and sell at 330,000. So they say, okay, but who is Odai? Odai is a team member. It belongs to Lofty AI. So when you see that, Odai sold to Lofty AI, actually this is a team member. This is Lofty selling to Lofty. And Odai probably bought at 200. So bought at 200 and sell at 330,000. He's a magician. Odai, the magician. I really want to know how it's possible to make so much money so fast. unless this is not the fair price of this property. So you see, guys, how to do the due diligence. Be really careful, you know, when you invest. Always check the fair price of the property to make sure you're not buying something that is overpriced. And don't focus only on the percentage, you know, on the yield. Here it's 7%. It's not that bad. Okay. So you will get the rent for 7%. This one is including an expectation of capital gain. So this one you can really trust. Given that it's already overpriced. So this one is just that you believe in it or not. But the problem will be when you will want to sell it, you know, in a couple of years, you want to sell your shares. Then you discover that on the market, maybe the price, maybe it was overpriced and you don't succeed to sell it for 340,000, but maybe you manage to sell it just for what was the fair price originally, which was 200,000. Okay. So, yeah, be really careful who is selling to who, and be careful that they are not belonging to the same family or the same team member or the same company that try to generate like a new purchase price, artificially. Guys, that's it for today. I wish you a very happy day. Bye bye.